What is a digital fingerprint? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I got asked this question the other day and it really got me to thinking and investigating exactly what goes into making a digital fingerprint. When I walked away from it, I'm already not particularly concerned about cookies. I'm even less concerned about cookies now because I understand that digital fingerprints can take their place at a moment's notice, it seems. What is a digital fingerprint? A digital fingerprint is really nothing more than a collection of information that is sent by your browser every time you visit a web page. It's not nefarious. This is information that's used to display web pages. It's used to communicate back and forth between your machine and the web server that's displaying the page. It includes information about your computer. What operating system are you running? What screen resolution are you running at? How fast is your machine? How are some of these odd things set on your machine? There are various options that you may or may not necessarily be aware of, but that are configurable. The interesting thing about this information is A, there's a lot of it, and the combination of all of these different pieces of information is extremely likely to be unique to your browser on your machine. Let me show you real quick what that means, what might be in a digital fingerprint. I'm looking at miunique.org. It's one of a couple of different places that will show you what is included in a digital fingerprint. I'm going to click on View My Browser Fingerprint. It'll take a few seconds to do whatever the heck it does. And yes, amongst the 800,000 fingerprints, this machine, this browser on this machine is unique. That means that the information that this browser sends to the websites that I visit can be combined in such a way to identify this browser on this machine. What kind of information are we talking about? Well, if we go down, if we scroll down here, you'll see that there are a lot of different pieces of information. The user agent is basically the information that says, this is the browser you're using. That's a user agent. But it also includes things like the operating system that you happen to be running on, or a number of other randomish kinds of things. And you can see here, Mozilla 5, Windows NT 10, Win 64, it tells I'm running 64-bit Windows. This is Chrome, but it's not. This is actually Edge. It's got characteristics of other browsers. The idea is that this is a lot of information that changes a lot from machine to machine, from version to version, from person to person. There are various other settings, like can I accept gzip or compressed information? What language am I running? What site was I on at the time I went here? Other headers. If we fire up JavaScript, it can do things like, okay, Win32, but it's 64-bit, cookies are enabled, here's the time zone that I'm in, here's the language that I'm using. This one I found really, really interesting. This is called Canvas, but they essentially draw certain characters in certain ways and display them. How they are displayed at the pixel by pixel level varies depending on a number of different characteristics of your machine. I found that one was fascinating. There are a whole lot of pieces of information that go into what might be considered to be your machine and identifies your machine, your browser, as being unique. Once you collect all of this information and associate it with this browser, like I said, when I go from site to site to site, this information stays the same. It's unique to me, but it stays the same, which means that a site's paying attention to it could track me. Now, I want to be clear about something. They can track this browser on this machine. If they're looking at this information, even if I've got cookies completely turned off, they can tell that I've gone from this site to that site to that site. Again, if all of those sites are using this fingerprinting technology to identify the visitors to their site. But they're not tracking me. They're tracking this browser. They're tracking where this browser has been. Except, what happens when on one of those sites, you tell them who you are, you log in. So if you're on a site that uses this kind of tracking and you log in, now this site says, hey, you know what? This digital fingerprint, this unique collection of information that identifies this specific browser on this specific machine, Leo just logged in. So that means this set of information can now identify Leo as he goes across different websites around the internet. So, can you avoid digital fingerprinting? The short answer is no, not really. Like I said, none of this information is unique to tracking. None of this information honestly has anything to do with tracking. It's all about helping websites provide you with a better experience. They need to know your screen resolution, what platform you're on. If you've ever gone to a download of some sort and it automatically shows you the Windows download instead of the Mac download because you're on a Windows platform, this is the information that went into them being able to do that. That's essentially a good thing, except that all of this information can simply be combined and used in a way that has unintended consequences. Allows you to be tracked, sort of. So, why I don't care? Remember, I said I don't care about cookies anymore. I never really cared about cookies that much to begin with, but even without cookies, there are so many different ways that websites can track what it is you're doing, where you're going, what you're viewing, that I almost want to say resistance is futile. And in fact, that's part of one of the article titles that I've got about one of the alternatives, super cookies and ever cookies and no cookies at all, resistance is futile. That's an article that talks about some of these alternative tracking mechanisms, including fingerprinting. It's inevitable. No matter what I do, no matter how I go about my day, I'm being tracked. I don't care. The reason I don't care is because I, as an individual, am not that interesting. What they care about are groups of people. People like me that all go to this site, great. Let's show this site in advertisements to other people like me. Most of tracking, the vast majority of tracking, I'm convinced, is all about simply showing you ads that you're more likely to click on. It's all about making money. Yep, there are scenarios that it can be used in more nefarious ways, but for the most part, none of us really need to worry about that. Now, there are approaches to trying to fight digital fingerprinting and other tracking technologies. I'm also going to point you to coveryourtracks.eff.org. It's another site that will show you your digital fingerprint or a version of your digital fingerprint. I'm going to go ahead and test my browser. It goes through essentially the same analysis that miunique.org went through and collects a bunch of information about this browser and about my computer, the characteristics of it that make it effectively unique. Now, in this case, I have what they're referring to as strong protection against web tracking because I'm blocking ads and blocking invisible trackers. And yet, my browser still has a unique fingerprint. The way that I'm blocking, by the way, is that I believe I have uBlock Origin installed here. And many browsers are now also blocking some of the tracking mechanisms by default. But I still have a unique fingerprint. Here's the information that goes into all of that fingerprint, and you can see there's a bunch of it. But what's interesting, and one of the reasons that I talk about this particular site, is that it does include this. How can I use my results to be more anonymous? And they do suggest installing things like an ad blocker, like uBlock Origin, or in their case, they have Privacy Badger, which is not an ad blocker. It's actually more designed to block the kinds of things that are used for tracking. The bottom line here is that you can't block everything and still use the internet. Some of the pushback I get is, well, just use something like Tor or use a VPN. Well, first of all, a VPN doesn't hide in any of this. You're still unique across a VPN. The only thing a VPN did was encrypt the connection between your machine and the VPN service so that people in between can't spy on you. But the people at the other end, they still see what they saw. Tor can actually obfuscate a lot of this at an extremely high price. Performance. Tor, every time I've tried to use it, has been unusably slow. But maybe that's a price worth paying if you're doing something that's super sensitive and you really care about. The bottom line here, though, is that understanding how easily identifiable you are is a step not towards trying to figure out how to block all this stuff, but how to, if necessary, change your behavior, understanding that, yeah, you could be tracked. For most of us, it doesn't matter. I don't change my behavior at all. I keep doing what I'm doing. Depending on what you're doing, you might want to do something else. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/148742. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.